Joining me this week is Sky News contributor and PR guru, Prue MacSween. Prue, thank you for joining me. Let's start in Melbourne, where else? Where climate change craziness led to protesters super gluing themselves to a Picasso painting. Have a look. Prue, one of the protesters boasted that we prepared long and hard for this, and he also said that he'd do it again. He said essentially to be successful in this work, if they call it work, you have to disrupt people. Have they succeeded in converting you, Prue?
Sadly, not for some weird reason, Rita. I mean, it was interesting. Some of the comments on Twitter were that why doesn't the museum erect a glass box around these two and exterminate them or watch them slowly become extinct? But you know,
we don't endorse that, Prue.
No, we don't.
We do not endorse.
I got some
starving protesters
out of it. But isn't it interesting that they chose the Picasso, who was a bit of a rebel? He was into cubism and surrealism, and now he's into extinctionism.
Womanizing.
You know, whatever. Yeah, exactly. But these morons, it's so sad they've got a pea brain and picking that picture, because what was the relevance? I mean, a Korean War, it just didn't resonate on any level. They just looked stupid. But of course, they got a slap on the wrist. And here they are walking the streets again, plotting and vowing to do another.
Absolutely. Vowing proudly to do it again and saying, watch out, there'll be more. And I'm sure there will be. And we've seen lefties losing it in London as well. Let's have a look. Look at the antics of these animal rebellion protesters in Harrods, of all places, creating an almighty mess for some minimum wage worker to clean up. The footage of this just goes on and on. Here they are destroying delicious cheeses. I mean, why would you do that? I mean, that is something that is unforgivable in my book, Prue, destroying cheese.
Oh, exactly. But, you know, they're poor little rich kids probably, and, you know, no respect. It really worries me. I think tonight's losers are probably the worst we've ever had, because they're just a terrible reminder of a generation of spoilt brats. And I know the Extinction Rebellions in this particular instance were oldies, but, you know, generally speaking, you know, we've got this snowflake generation that's been spoilt by, you know, their baby boomer parents. They've been fed rubbish throughout their lives during the education system, and they have no respect for anyone. And it's just so appalling to see this. And they never suffer any repercussions.
Look at them. They're just destroying. No, and then, you know, they won't be cleaning that up. There'll be some poor worker who has to stay back and clean up that mess. It is just despicable. And they think they're heroes behaving like in this manner.